for Fernando and Teddy, right here in the middle.
Joaquin Muniz with the Bay of California. Fernando, you guys on the win. Can you talk about that final drive and just everything that comes with that?
Yeah, it was a phenomenal drive. Definitely the best he put together all season, 98 yards. It was a great Stanford punt, and I mean, it was incredible. It was incredible. It was a special moment, and it was a big game moment. And I would say that credit to our entire offense, our coaching staff, for putting together an amazing drive. And we ended up winning, especially when the lights turned bright. We all turned brighter. So it was a very special moment for the offense and for all of us.
Steve Carter from the San Francisco Chronicle. I'll ask you both kind of a similar question. Fernando, I was told by some people who were watching the telecast that in your post-game interview, you said it was maybe the most emotional you've ever been at during a game or after a game. And Teddy, you said growing up here, you knew the import of the big game, but do you have a different perspective now having been through it?
Yeah, I mean, having gone through it, got to get a nice history lesson, which, you know, add some appreciation for, you know, just the importance and significance of this game. And yeah, just to be a part of it and get the win in the way we did, it's an amazing feeling. You know, for me as a senior, this being my last year, couldn't ask for more. So super appreciative of this guy going 98 yards in the fourth quarter. And yeah, just super happy to get the win.
Yeah, first of all, I'm really appreciative of this guy and the defense. The defense held their own, and I mean, they're the reason we won the game. Honestly, we should have scored more points, but it didn't work out that way. However, we did win, and it was, I would say it's the most, by far, the most emotional win. As Stanford, so many emotions. You had the 2004 team out here. This is to get us bowl eligible. And there's just so much on the line. And for us, and for myself, have a tough first three quarters to then come out and then win on the 98-yard drive. You couldn't write a story better like that. And it was like an Aaron Rodgers or Jared Goff drive, and it was just extremely special. And once we scored, I mean, I honestly burst out in tears, especially after the game. It was special. I'll definitely remember this forever.
Neil Wachtel, Daily Californian. Aaron Rodgers, actually, speaking of him, we know that he came to speak to you guys yesterday in the locker room. Will you tell us a little bit about what that meant to you guys?
Yeah, so being a quarterback, Aaron Rodgers, everybody knows Aaron Rodgers, and he's one of the greatest of all time. So having him come in our team meeting yesterday and speak about that the Cal-Stanford rivalry has to be the most important rivalry of his life, and him dealing with the Chicago Bears and the Green Bay Packers, their great rivalry, it means a lot to us. And I think it showed everybody, because especially nowadays with the transfer portal, you never really understand how big the big game is until you play in one. And so to have him, of that prominent of a figure, make those remarks about the big game, I think it really definitely, it inspired our team. It inspired our team, and to have the entire 2004 team was definitely special. And it was a similar story. Aaron Rodgers said that his junior year, they were 6-6, and they beat Stanford to become bowl eligible. And then the next year was the 2004 year where they were supposed to go to the Rose Bowl. So, not saying that history doesn't repeat itself, but I think it does.
Thomas Dunn, right for California. Teddy, so you kind of hinted at it a little bit, but being from the Bay Area, did this take on any additional meaning, not only going from watching these games to being a significant contributor in these games?
Absolutely. Growing up, you always know when the big game is. You always hear about it. I have family who's alumni from both sides, so yeah, it meant a ton for me to come back home and you know, just play for Cal in the first place and then to get to play in the big game and to win it just means a ton to me, and I'm super grateful for this team and you know, for them just accepting me and to be able to contribute. Like you said, it was an amazing feeling.
And then Fernando, you also hinted at this post game about how cathartic that was to get over the top and finish something off from all the work you guys have put in. How cathartic did it feel once Jonathan scored that touchdown?
The only feeling that was better than that has to be beating Teddy in ping pong. But to give a little context, Teddy and I actually play ping pong like every lunch, and it's always double overtime game, and I think it actually improves both our reactions. But it's the big game. It's the big game, and to have an ending like that for our seniors, for Craig, for Miles Williams, for all those guys that have been there so long, that have fought through so many years, and especially this year, like we've had, everyone knows, the four games by a total of 9 points. So to have that, but to be able to be on the flip side of that comeback win, those games you do it for the seniors, and you do it so they can end on a high note, especially like Teddy, who's going to be playing the NFL a long time. So I'll be able to take a picture of this interview and show my kids that I was once friends with Teddy.
One last quick one. Three big games you've been on the roster for, three wins, three field scores. Is this a feeling that's ever going to get old?
Never. Never. And I have to say, each big game just keeps on getting better and better. So a lot of high expectations for next year's big game. I know that's looking a lot in the future. However, it's the field storm. I mean, that's just, it's incredible. It's incredible. There's no feeling like it. To see the monsoon of Cal fans waving back and forth when it's the fourth quarter, the noise. There's honestly no other environment except the Miami game like that. So to see the support, to see everybody raining down, and know it means a lot to the Cal alumni, Cal community, and it means a lot to us to be able to put that together and get the X.
Fernando and Teddy, your backs were really against the wall down 21-7 pretty late in the game, and it really took a lot of defensive stops and critical offensive drives to make this thing happen. Can you talk a little bit about what you guys were saying to each other to rally each other? And Fernando, did your eyes light up when you started to see those play calls going down the field? Because that's not happened a lot in recent games.
Yeah, I mean, they're great play calls. I don't control the play calls. However, I will say that giving our guys a chance was that's what we do in big time moments. The receivers want the ball in their hands. I want the ball in my hands, be able to throw it downfield one on one, and that's what we do best. And there's a couple opportunities that we missed here and there, but overall, I know that our squad, our guys, we're going to beat them. So it was incredibly special to have that 98-yard drive. And although we were down, great by the defense. I mean, they really held up. So they held them. I mean, I don't really know the stat, but they held them, I think, like three or four consecutive drives and just like three and outs that gave us the opportunity to have those critical offensive drives. So I really thought that our team in the second half meshed well together and was able to show a lot of resiliency, which led us to maintain the X.
Yeah, I mean, this is college football, you know, no lead is safe, especially, you know, when got a quarterback like Fernando leading these drives in the fourth quarter. But for us as a team, it was like we didn't necessarily like the way we played, and you know, we weren't like happy with the situation we were in, but we knew that, you know, defensively we were getting stops after stop after stop, and we knew the offense was going to drive down the score. So it was never ever over in our minds, and we just played complimentary football in the fourth quarter as a team effort, and we're able to get it done, which is a great feeling.
Fernando, what were you thinking when you went onto the field from the 2-yard line?
98 yards on the score. At that moment, that's the moment of a kid when you watch Aaron Rodgers, Jared Goff, Tom Brady go on that field and they lead the comeback game-winning drive. It's exactly what I thought of there. Our offense have worked so hard for this moment. This is the moment. This is what you play for. And to be able to come out victorious, it was very emotional.
Can you talk about Jonathan Brady and what he was able to do for you guys with those two touchdown catches? Describe him a little bit and talk about just what he's contributed.
Yeah, a lot of people refer to Jonathan Brady as JB, and JB, he's a special player, and he makes special catches. He had the last two touchdown catches, and I mean, every touchdown catch, Tron's back shoulder catch, the scramble drill to JB, and the last one where he got held and he extended for the ball, those are all spectacular catches. And when the lights were bright, he turned brighter. And our receiver corps turned brighter. Our offense in totality became a brighter unit. And to see a guy like JB work so hard throughout the offseason, every one of us being through ups and downs, JB's a guy that I know I could rely on. And so when the moment came down to it, cover zero, last play of the game, I know I'm going to take a shot. I know I can give JB a chance. And I hope that, you know, JB and I, especially with all our receivers, like Tobias, Isaiah, Jack, Corey, Mikey, Tron, I know we're all going to grow through this and have a great last two games.
Fernando, kind of going back to what Jake's question about the beginning of the drive, tell you how old I am, but I know you're a student of football history. when the 49ers were in Super Bowl 23 and they had their winning drive starting around their own 10 or 20. And the beginning of the drive, the story goes, guys got in the huddle and Joe Montana, to kind of lighten the mood, said, "Hey, there's John Candy in the stands." Did you have any kind of comment to the team at the beginning of that drive to either lighten the load or get guys even more pumped?
Yeah, Joe Montana, what a guy. I wish that I had his remarks and able to lighten the mood. Unfortunately, I was a little bit, or maybe fortunately because it worked, I was a little bit more serious that this is why we went on the camping trip. This is why we did Saturday walkthroughs when no one wanted to come in. This is why we watch film every night. This is the reason. This is the reason. This is what it all comes down to. And so we know that we're a great offense. When we execute, good results happen. And that was a result of it.
Last question for these guys right here.
Josh Kamen, Dayton, California. And Teddy, can you tell me from a defensive perspective what you thought the most pivotal moment of the game was? And then Fernando, I know you've been talking a lot about that 98-yard drive, but from a specific moment perspective on the offensive side.
Yeah, I think there was a few moments, and it was really just those third and fourth downs in the second half. I think they when we fumbled the kickoff and they had the ball down in their 20 or whatever, to get a stop there and then to have them miss the field goal was huge. You know, we really had our backs against the wall at that point. And then I think that we got a third down stop around the 50-yard line, forced them to punt. And they had that really good punt leading to the 98-yard drive. And then obviously that final drive, getting a stop on fourth down was huge. And then allowing the offense to ice the game for us was massive. So I think really just that whole fourth quarter was full of pivotal moments, and we were happy to perform well and do what we need to do.
Yeah, I believe the pivotal moment in the game, there was the first drive that we hit the field goal, that we were able to get Jack on the flat for around 20 yards, and I think the pivotal moment of the game was when Tron Grizzell had the wheel catch for around, I don't know how many yards it was, but he had a spectacular wheel catch, and at that moment, it inspired confidence, like, hey, we're going to take shots on these guys at the end of the game because we're going to need to push the ball downfield, and we can do it. We can do it with ease, and we're going to do it, and we're going to win the game. And yeah, so I should be proud of all those guys.
All right, thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Bears. God bless.